It's a lot of stuff, man, and it's like, it's kind of discouraging. I'm not like, you have to like,
discouraging in what way?
It's like all this stuff. You have to first learn yourself, figure yourself out, get yourself where you are in a good, acceptable place to be in a relationship. Then you have to find somebody that's in the same exact state that you're in. You have to be attracted to them. You like your purpose has to align together. All these things have to come kind of perfect for it to kind of work out. Like, and then, like you said, that's like a 1% chance of the 1% girl or guy that you're looking for.
No, okay, so let me help change that discouraging feeling.
I feel like I'm not the only one.
So, no, and I agree with you. I think that there are people who are listening to this who probably feel the exact same way as you. Like, this is a lot.
Yes.
And because it's a lot and it's overwhelming, it can be discouraging. Mm-hmm. So, one, you said there's a 1% chance. All right, no. That person may represent 1% in the world, but I believe there's a 100% chance you're going to come across that person.
Got you.
All right? The question is, will you be ready when they come? Now, yes, I can't sugarcoat that part. Yeah. There is still work involved here. Yeah. I think where we've messed up as a society is we're not raising good husbands and wives no more. We've come to a place where we are destroying the whole family unit. We're saying marriage is not important, blah, 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 blah. And I'm not sitting here to say everyone has to get married. So even if we don't look at it as good husbands and wives, we're not raising good partners. Mm. All right? At some of my events, I was telling the women, I said, listen, and this can go for men too, but I said, some of y'all are raising a little boy who's the exact man you complain about right now. Mm-hmm. All right? You're setting it up this way. You're not instilling character into him. You're not giving him responsibility. You're coddling him to where when he grows up, he's going to look to go from his mother to a woman who's going to be like his mother but has sex with him. That's what it is. That's all it boils down to. All right? And so we have to start with how we are raising the children. Mm. And if we got started earlier in our lives to focus on our character development, we would not be as discouraged, because now we're not looking at late 20s, 30s, 40s, and we're like, dang, I got to do all this work now to get somebody. Yeah. Like, at that point, yeah, it feels harder. But imagine if you started in high school.
Yeah.
And to some people, they're going to say, well, that's too young. No, like, why aren't we working on ourselves earlier? That doesn't mean you have to be in a relationship earlier.
Yeah.
But why not figure yourself out sooner? If we gave more time and attention to that, even in our careers, there are so many people right now who are in pointless jobs. Why? Because they never focused on developing their purpose and career early. Right. All right? And they didn't set out a plan or vision for it. If you're a guy and you knew from the beginning you wanted to be a lawyer, so to speak, all right? Let's say you want to work somewhere in IT. If you created that vision early on, then at 18, you could be working as a technical rep somewhere. Mm-hmm. All right? Working your way up. Building up the experience. So that by the time you're in your 20s, you got so much experience and knowledge, you